The United States is confronting a worsening crisis at the southern border. Migrants fleeing their home countries in droves, some hoping it will be easier to get into the United States under President Biden than it was under President Donald Trump. And let's be honest, the images out of the southern border are heartbreaking. Just as heartbreaking as they were back in 2018 when we traveled to the border near El Paso, Texas. We were there because Seattle Mayor Jenny Durkan and other Democrats were at the border trying to gain access into facilities where migrant children were being held and railing against the policies of the Trump administration. So nearly 3 years later, what does Mayor Durkan think now about what's unfolding at the border under a different president?
The situation at the southern border, President Biden, refuses to call it a crisis. Do you believe that there is a crisis at the southern border?
I think that we have a crisis generally globally right now. We are seeing so many more economic and climate refugees, and we will continue to see those. And so we can't be surprised that our southern border is reflecting that. I am happy that the president is recognizing we need to do more for children who are coming here unaccompanied and making sure that they have places to stay that are safe, sanitary, and that they're held in great conditions. Better conditions, let me make that very clear, that I didn't mean that that's great because no one wants to be holding those children. But the other thing that's very different from the previous administration is no one is using separating children from their parents as a strategy. That was the stated strategy of the previous administration, and it was wrong. They said, don't come here, because if you do, we will take your children from you. Then they did take their children from them, and then they deported the parents without their children. That was immoral, and it remains immoral. We still don't know where the parents are for hundreds of children that were kept by the previous administration. So I'm hoping that the president finds a way forward. That it's incredibly challenging at the southern border. We have to admit it's challenging, and it won't get any better because of the economics that are present in the globe. So it's not gonna be a quick fix or an easy fix, but I do appreciate that the president is starting from the basis of, we will treat people as compassionately and humanely as we can, and recognize that some people come here as refugees with the right to enter this country.
That being said, we don't really know how they're being treated. You know, you went down to the southern border during this crisis in the Trump administration. I stood with you at a fence outside of El Paso where migrant teens were being held, and you were upset, along with other mayors, that you weren't being allowed inside to see the conditions that these teenagers were being held in. The Biden administration so far has not let reporters inside those very same facilities. Do you believe that the Biden administration should give reporters access?
I don't know all the facts for that, but I think you should have transparency and access. And I think that it's really important for any administration to be open and forthright with what they're doing. I know that I've seen a lot of pictures from the border of Republicans in Texas, making claims. But I've also talked to some of the mayors in Texas, and they say that the situation is much different. But we need to hold every administration accountable, and we want to make sure that this administration follows through with what some of its promises are. But that also includes getting immigration reform. And if the Republicans in Congress continue to block even the ability to keep the kids, who are now some adults, on DACA here, let's start really getting a humane path forward.
Really quickly, because I think we're both running out of time. It's just fascinating to me. Like I said, I was, and I would perhaps be at the southern border if it weren't for the COVID crisis, which didn't exist when you went with Democratic mayors. You guys went down there kind of in a group, and certainly to send a message. And now you see Republican lawmakers doing the same thing that you guys did under the Trump administration. Basically the same situation when it comes to the crisis. Is it just political theater? Is it political theater?
No, and I got to stop you there because I think, it's great your program's called The Divide. And one thing we don't do to create a divide is to have false equivalencies.
What's false equivalency about it, though?
You do not have a president of the United States who stands before the people and says, don't come here or we will take your children from you, and then follows through with that threat. Using children as a tool to enforce immigration strategy is immoral. And so that is a false equivalency. Now, can they, do I don't have all the details of what they're doing, but I think we have to be very careful to say, will there continue to be pressure on the southern border? Absolutely. And is it going to be incredibly challenging and a crisis at some times? Unquestionably. But the moral standpoint from which we start, I think, has a great deal to do on how we treat what happens down at the border.
Yeah, but we can all agree, politics aside, that whether it was under Trump or under Biden, the situation at the southern border involving an influx of migrants is a really challenging situation for the government to deal with.
100%. And I think, and followed from that is, in the way you cannot deal with it, is to just unilaterally decide you will take children from their parents and have no plan to reunite them. You will use the children as weapons and think that they can be a deterrent. I think that was what was so different about the approach of the previous administration.
And look, the mayor is right. The president, President Trump, did talk about family separation as a possible deterrent. And it's very clear that the priorities of the two presidents and the priorities of the two major parties are vastly different.